Tonight, a Channel 4 Action News investigation finds the city of Pittsburgh is buying millions of dollars worth of fire trucks from a company that used to employ the fire chief.
Investigative reporter Paul Van Osdol joins us now with the story. Paul?
Well, Mike, one day before Darrell Jones became fire chief in Pittsburgh, he was a salesman for a small company called Keystone Fire Apparatus. For years, that company tried to sell the city fire trucks, but it never won a contract until after Jones became chief. Now, Keystone has won three straight contracts, even though they've never been the initial low bidder. Pittsburgh firefighters responded to this high-rise fire back in March using brand new trucks. The city may have financial problems, but it's on a fire truck spending spree. Eight trucks bought in the past 2 years, and nine more on the way. Total cost, $8 million. All of them purchased through this Kennedy Township company, Keystone Fire Apparatus. They are the local dealer for a Michigan-based manufacturer. Pittsburgh Fire Chief Darrell Jones says he worked for Keystone for about 3 years. State records show Jones was a licensed salesperson for Keystone from 2000 to 2005, 2 years before he went to work for the city.
So the last three bids have all gone to the same company.
And that's true.
And it's a company that you have a history with.
I have a history with that company. That's true. There's no change in that. But I did not influence the bid.
But after Keystone won its first contract 2 years ago, four competitors sent the City Equipment Leasing Authority this letter obtained by Channel 4 Action News. It details complaints about the bid process, including that the city used a highly proprietary specification that favors one manufacturer. Days later, Jones sent this email to Keystone President Thomas Ball, saying he had talked to Jake Harvey of First Vehicle Services, the company that repairs all city trucks. One of the company representatives who signed the complaint letter also does work for First Vehicle. "I told Jake to rattle his cage," Jones says in the email.
What I did after that letter went out, I called each one of the manufacturers up and said, "Hey, is this the way you guys do business?"
Were you retaliating against this company for writing this letter about you?
No, I don't retaliate. I believe in negotiating and talking and working things out. Retaliation isn't my thing.
Harvey of First Vehicle did not return my calls. Dan Coyle, one of the people who signed the complaint letter, declined to comment. Last year, Keystone won another contract to supply trucks, even though a different company, Precision Fire Apparatus, was $15,000 cheaper. Jones said Precision's bid was tossed after a committee of firefighters found 64 items of concern in their proposal. But in this email to Jones, Precision said most of those were typographical errors or oversights, nothing that would prevent the company from meeting the city's expectations.
Even if they are typos, let's say it's not my responsibility to make sure the quality of your proposal.
Jones says he disclosed his connection to Keystone Fire with members of the Equipment Leasing Authority. That agency purchases trucks with input from the Fire Bureau.
Was your belief all the members were aware of that?
Yes.
City Councilman Bruce Krause is a member of the authority.
Did you have any idea that the chief had a previous relationship with this company?
No, you brought it to my attention. This is the first I'm hearing of it, and it was not disclosed to me.
He said he wasn't aware of your history with this company.
I don't know, but that's my understanding, is that they were aware.
2 years ago, when Keystone won its first contract to sell the city fire trucks, 10 companies bid on the deal. But earlier this year, when the city was looking to buy more trucks, only two companies submitted bids, including Keystone, which won the contract after the other lower bid was thrown out. The city controller says when only two companies bid on a multi-million dollar contract, prices go up and taxpayers lose.
You get to a point after a number of bids where competitors then stop bidding because they feel that the decision's been made.
Keystone's president says his company has won millions in city business on its own merits without the help of his former employee.
They were tired of just being a number out there, and they wanted that more personalized feeling, and we're giving it to them.
It really raises real questions. When he used to work for the company that ends up winning a bid, the perception is not a good one.
Now, the fire chief in Latrobe told me he was shocked that only one other company besides Keystone even tried to bid on the most recent Pittsburgh contract. He told me that even a department as small as Latrobe requires at least three manufacturers to bid on trucks to make sure they get a good deal for taxpayers. Paul Van Osdol, Channel 4 Action News.